Welcome. Thanks for joining in.
Let's look into PytestBDD and how you can do data-driven testing, that is using multiple input values and run the same test scenario.
I'm Kumar and welcome to my channel on tech and tutorials.
One feature of PytestBDD which I would like to show you in this session. This feature is called ScenarioOutline of PytestBDD and it's very similar to the Pytest parameterized functionalities. So let us look into that in this session. So let me start by adding the feature file scenarioOutline.feature file. Okay, so this is the feature file. I have just named it as scenarios outline. But you see here, so what we are doing actually. So in case if we want to run the same scenarios for multiple inputs, in this case, this is the inputs which will go into this scenario. And as I was saying earlier, this is similar to the Python's parameterized functionalities. So this is also similar to where we were parsing the givens statement. But in this case, what we are using is we are using the angular brackets for each of these variables, start, deposit, draw, and final, which when we run this test or when we run this scenario, all these variables will be resolved to whatever we defined in this examples section. So again, as I was saying, we want to run the same scenario with multiple inputs. And this is going to be helpful in case if we want to try out the same test with multiple input parameters. Okay, and one more point, you can define this example in the table once for the whole feature file, and this table can be shared across all your scenarios in the same feature file. Okay, so let's move ahead and write our step definitions. BDD outline. Let me quickly note down all the step definitions and then we'll come and describe and go through them. Okay, so we have, since we are working on PyTest, I forgot to put the test keyword, test_BDD outline. Okay, so let us go through this quickly and then we'll see how this scenarios outlines work and then we'll execute this one. Okay, so the top part is the same thing which we have for all the other tests. We are reading from our feature file and then, okay, so this is also the same. We are not using the whole feature file. We are just pointing to one of the scenario. Okay, yeah. So in this test also, we are using the dictionary. The intention is to help learn a little bit about Python also, because that's why I keep on using some of these data structures in Python. Now, in this case also, we are using the dictionary data structure. So you are going to need all these data structures while you start to code or while you start to work on PyTest and Python. So it's better to learn or know some of this in case if you are new to Python programming. So this you might have already seen in our earlier session. We are resolving this first variable start and then we are using that in our test function. And we are using the dictionary and we are starting with the key start and the start value. And we are using a target fixture where it will give us the dictionary, cucumbers. And the next one, we are using the same fixture, target fixture from this given statement. And we are using it in our when step definition. Okay, and then here we are using the same dictionary and we are updating with another key, deposit. And also I am printing the dictionaries for each of these test step definitions so that we get to see what comes after each of this step. And then deposit and withdraw, same target fixture we are using here. And then in the final step, then statement, we are actually asserting on the final value of the cucumbers. Okay, coming back here, if you see, so we have 12 start and we deposit 5 and we withdraw 7 and the final is 10. And then this one and the second input value is 10, 5, 20 and minus 5. Okay, now let us try to run this, run our test module and see the output. Okay, so yeah, this is the test output and seems to be working fine. And you see very similar to our Python parameterized, you see an output where it shows the input values with each of the test name. Okay, that's good. Yeah, that's about the scenarios outline. Finally, let us see one negative scenario where we add some wrong value here. Let's put a minus 7 here. And let us also do one thing. Let us actually add one more row to verify this one. So our second input value should fail and the third one should pass. So now let us try to run this and see the output. Okay, so let's see that now. So the first one, this is the first one, 12, 5, 7 and 10. And this is the second one where minus 5 is not equal to minus 7. This is the second one which gets failed intentionally. And you see all the assertions failed and all. You see the failure here. And this one's the third one. And this one's the third one. Test underscore outline. And this one's a pass. So you see in the end, one failed and two passed. Okay. So that's good then. So, yep. So this completes this session, and we have seen about the scenarios outline, and which is very similar to Python parameters, and how you can use PytestBDD to parameterize your test or have different inputs for your scenarios. So thank you so much, and
well, don't forget to hit the like button and put a comment if this has helped you.
See you in the next.